Top Cut, Top Cut.
Okay, as you see right now, we have Hao. Oh Gott, what is this name?
Hao Truong.
Hao Truong versus Patrick Dublin again.
Yeah.
We saw him in the last round of Swiss.
Yeah, Orcus Danger.
Also, we have Christian Thomas versus Zoe Weber right now.
Yeah.
Tobias Hertrich versus Kevin Schlieben. We also saw him in the Swiss rounds before. Lukas Wagner versus Nikita Herbst.
Yeah.
So two people we didn't feature today.
Yeah, I once dated a girl called Nikita, by the way.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So what we're going to say right now, or see right now, sorry, is the Thunder versus...
August Danger, the email the first, match.
The first August deck we see today.
Yeah, that's right. And I'm really hyped to see this. Remember when I tried to showcase you the combos?
Yeah.
Yeah, I messed it up like a lot because I didn't play the deck ever. I was just trying to make them up basically from scratch. And I'm excited to see them in action, like well performed with a good know-how and a basic plan behind it. So...
Also, it's a team intern match. It's
E-Man
versus E-Man.
Yeah. How?
But as we see, Patrick has the better standing.
Yeah, but that doesn't matter in Top Cut.
No, it doesn't matter. But in fact, he did a constant gameplay around the tournament.
Yeah. So. Horror was banished to summon another Orcist Nightmare, and as the Orcist Seer, as I call it, is already in graveyard, I think it's Skeleton. good know-how. Okay, I like the how jokes in the chat already. So Galantea is summoned back by Skeleton, and then Summon Sorceress can summon Baguette du Monde. This card it's actually called Baguette in French. Now, I think Baguette and the Galantea can now be used to go into Rusty Bardiche, the PK link. The PK link can then set the PK spell, the rank up spell, and send Silent Boots to the graveyard, while Silent Boots will search out the cloak. No, not cloak. The trap card.
The trap card.
What's the name? Brigadine. Shady Brigadine. You can summon the Brigadine, and then Baguette will be banished from the graveyard to summon Horror back, and they can be overlaid to Evil Swarm Thanatos. So Thanatos can then activate the effect to not get destroyed by a Pancratops or something like that. And also, rank up will be used if there is no Kaiju, which I don't think there will be. Patrick looks really annoyed, actually, because he knows he has no out. and the judges are trying to read all the cards. And yeah, then we will see an Azathoth as a thought that will deny any play that Patrick can make, because it says no monster effects whatsoever. And look at Patrick's hand; it looks pretty monstery. So they are discussing about something I don't know what. Maybe it's the Galantea effect. If you can actually, no, I don't know why. Actually.
At this point, it could be really, really, really important what Patrick draw.
I don't think he has an out in
the
main deck.
Is there an out? No.
No, it could either be a Kaiju. No, it could only be a Kaiju, actually. Or if he doesn't play Evil Swarm Thanatos, then it could be the Pancratops, but there's no reason not to play Thanatos.
But even if he had the Kaiju, what would be the follow-up play that should possibly keep him into the match?
But then he just does his Danger Thunderdrink stuff. Like if he has a Kaiju, there's no monster effects. He can activate monster effects. Because in the main phase one, Patrick has the player priority. So he can just summon a Kaiju over the Thanatos. So there is no monster that can be ranked up by the PK rank-up spell. But he actually did not go for Rusty Bardiche. He went into Longyearsu. So this looks like a Bomber Dragon play for Hao. No Phantom Knights. Weird. Did not expect that, actually. And Patrick looks like he didn't expect that either, because now he can actually play Yu-Gi-Oh! I mean, still Bomber Dragon board with like unlimited quick bursts is still hard to out, of course. But there will be ways, right? I mean, it's not unlimited pops. Okay, so let's think. What does Hao have in graveyard? He can probably activate like a horror and summon the skeleton to blast everything, and then activate the skeleton to summon something back, and then he's out of quick effects that he can use to summon monsters. So he can only wipe the board twice. If Patrick manages to go into a Colossus, he just needs a Thunder Monster on board, then he can push the Colossus with Matrix and run over the Bomber Dragon, which would make House basically like his entire game plan useless, unless he manages to OTK through the Colossus or the board that Patrick will be able to.
So for Hao, it all is about timing.
Yeah, it's just the question.
Patience and timing.
Yeah, like if okay, just look at that. If Patrick tribute summons the Raw now, then he could immediately summon Colossus. If Hao doesn't want that, he summons a monster to blast the entire board. Then the Raw will trigger to summon Dark. If Hao manages to blow the board up again, then, oh, he also has, okay, or, oh no, Longyearsu doesn't matter right now. So if he manages to blow up the board again, then he can search a Hawk. Hawk effect will then be activated to summon one of the monsters back. Then he will have no effect left to blow the board, so he can just summon a Colossus. And so he's basically guaranteed to play through the entire board.
But is it possible from that point that he ends game one?
I don't really think that he can win game one turn.
They're not enough, no.
Yeah, but I think maybe Hao will scoop if he thinks that he can't out the board anymore. So, Colossus effect prevents him from being destroyed.
Patrick reading his own cards.
Yeah, I was actually curious why he benched two cards, because that is the protection effect of Titan. And now he activates the Raw effect to summon Dark. I was also curious why Dark wasn't on the field yet. It kind of looked like he wanted to attack with Colossus. But yeah. Okay, so basically he went for the tribute summon play, which was absolutely correct. Dark, Raw, the best card for that scenario. Absolutely. Let's see. I mean, I don't know what Hao is playing in his extra deck, and apparently he wasn't able to get a second rank 4 monster, so he couldn't rank up into Thanatos. Yeah. I think... Did he misplay that? Because there had to be a way...
On which point?
Because, like, you he shuffled back the Orcrist Horror with the Tower of Babel. I think that's the card. And if he didn't do it, then he could have used the Legacy Staff to summon the Horror back and then go into a rank 4 exceeds. So I am really confused as to what happened there.
I guess Patrick is also confused.
Yeah, I mean, I must miss something, right?
Okay.
Yeah, okay, this makes perfect sense. He fusion summons away the Colossus and the Matrix from hand, or does not necessarily fusion summon, but he just goes for a Titan and then tributes the Roar away. Oh no, the effect of Bomber Dragon comes through and destroys the Roar. Yeah, he could have just fused it up to a Colossus, actually. I don't know if he forgot about that or if he just did not want to. That's a bit weird. I always think that I'm missing something. Because you guys in the chat, you shouldn't forget that players most of the time focus on just like one deck to perfect their techniques with the deck. And we have to cast like all the decks. So it can happen that we miss out on something. So very good move by Patrick, discarding the Matrix as a response to Horror so that there is no way for Howe to chain to the Matrix, that he can get a guaranteed pop with the three-headed Thunder Dragon called Titan. So Skeleton is searched out and Howe does not look too happy. Like seriously, look, he looks really mad.
You would have too.
Yeah, sure. But I think he has to have messed up his combo in the first place because I don't know how this happened. Like in this combo, like he had a banished Horror. You have to have a banished Horror. He summoned the Orcus Nightmare with it. And then he summoned the Baguette du Monde. So
at some point there's something missing.
Yeah. No, it's really weird because he should have summoned the Sir actually and went into Galantea and then activated the Sir to summon back a monster to go into Rusty Bartish.
But this is the current status. See,
yeah.
Can't change it now. So what do you guess could Howe come back after this?
I mean, Orcus does not really rely too much on searching. So they can basically ignore Colossus. And if Patrick does not end up on any quick hand effects of the Thunder Dragons, then he is able to pop a lot of stuff. But still, he has to kind of out the monsters. But I think Howe could be able to go into a Borreload, because Borreload or Unicorn are still dark monsters. So the downside effects of the Orcus monsters, saying you can only special summon dark monsters after the resolve of this effect, can be easily ignored for those kind of monsters. So if he manages to go into Borreload, he can actually steal a Colossus and then use the effect to shrink the Titan that he goes back to 3,200 while he's being buffed now. And then eventually he can shrink it again next turn also to chain to the effect of a card in hand. So basically Howe is still in the game because of the resource management and the opportunity to always recycle the effects of the Tower of Babel. And the basic BA engine the deck has, like they have Graf being Horror and they have Sir being Skeleton, but they don't end on that because like they also have Baguette du Monde, which special summons from the banished pile, which is like one better BA than BA has, if I may say so. Okay, you have to stop these how jokes, actually. It's just not funny anymore. So what did he draw? Did he draw Denko Seka? He has Mothman and Bigfoot, as we can see.
So.
And It looks like a Danko Sacker, yeah.
Okay. So he
reveals Bigfoot now, hoping that it doesn't get hit. And he hits the Danko Sacker. Best hit for him.
Nice.
Definitely. So he draws a card now. Being Jackalope, I think. Yeah, he should really be in the game right now. Yeah, the Arcus engine is so good. So good. People have been ignoring it for like a tournament basically only, but so did he reveal the Jackalope over the Mothman? That is okay. Interesting, I'd say.
Do you think he did this on purpose? In his first turn? And hold back the material?
No, I see what he did there, actually. Also, Chet, he had a Mothman in hand the whole time. It's no reason to not go for the second. I think he's just not playing the Everthought engine. He had Mothman. He could have attempted to summon it. I think revealing Jackalope first was a big misplay. Because you always want to reveal your bad dangers first, the ones that cannot provide a special summon in any case. Like now I can just activate Mothman, draw a card, and discard it. If he had revealed Mothman first and discarded the Jackalope, then he would have had an extra summon and the draw and the Jackalope effect.
He also could have gone to the fort.
He would have had like one monster more and the card in hand more. So he top decked Nessie, fortunately for him. So he can search out another monster, which will be most likely the snake. Snake will be revealed and snake will be summoned then. And then we're nearly at the Borreload point. So that one is already in the game, basically. And don't forget about this entire Orcrist engine that he has. Like, I don't know, maybe he plays two summon sorcerers, so he could like combo off again. But this is very unlikely to be
value.
Yeah, so I just play three summon sorcerers. I play by combo like thrice in my deck. So yeah, if my opponent outs my unoutable board, and you can do it again. I like this attempt of not going for the pseudo FTK being Azathoth in the opponent's turn. I find it really cool that he goes for like the OG Orcus style. It's weird to say that because people don't know OG Orcus. But he goes for Bomber Dragon control, basically. And even if he couldn't stop Patrick from playing, he can still outvalue him because the Orcus are so crazy.
No, the camera is shaking. Of course, Patrick is horrified about what's going to happen to him.
So, four monsters sent to the graveyard. And this is a Borilodu.
There it is.
As we call him in Germany. So, Nico, you can stop asking the chat. I will just ask for you later on. And then I will tell you what sleeves he uses. So, Borreload just goes for the takeover, takes over Titan. Titan, funnily enough, also triggers, I think, when the opponent's thunder effects are activated in hand. So as soon as Patrick wants to activate like a hawk effect, Hao can just chain it and pop a card.
Ouch.
Yeah. Okay, so... Yeah, he also summoned back Long Ears with the Sir. It's crazy. The value is crazy. So, Orcus beste Decke, I think.
No, Patrick is very upset.
Yeah, like Long Ears is just getting resummoned all the time just for dips because he has 2,500 attack. Such a good card. I think the effect is if it is linked by a monster, or if it links to a monster, which would be, I think, left up. Yeah, left up. So basically, if you summon it in your extra monster zone, It points to one side of the opponent's field. If it points to a monster, then you can send it to the graveyard via Longiris's effect. And then it can't attack. By the way, I only know all the Orcus cards because of Julian Ewert. So shout outs at this point. You really helped me explaining the combo. Thank you.
Do you think Patrick has an option right there?
I mean, he has Chaos Dragon Levianir. So he can attempt to summon that one. I mean, he has a lot of resources in graveyard. You know, there is the Matrix. There is the Hawk. The Dark. And basically, this should be enough to come back with Levianir, because Levianir will be able to destroy two cards of his opponent. So this would be Titan and Longirsu. Hawk cannot respond, or it's not a response really, it's just a protection effect. So he cannot protect Titan because he doesn't have anything. He doesn't need Thunder Monsters in graveyard to protect Titan. That's only a Colossus thing. He can just banish any card if Titan gets destroyed by a card effect. Also, he has a Thunder Monster in grave, being Denko Sekka. So this one's hard now. So I think, yeah, the Levianir, great top deck. He also has a Dark in hand, so maybe Levianir wasn't. I think Levianir was the top deck. So you banish Matrix, probably. You banish Hawk, and probably like Collapse Serpent or the Jack. I don't see what the card next to the fusion is. I think another OG Thunder Dragon. The Levianir summon will get so much value. That's crazy. It can pop Longirsu. Does it target? Does Levianir target?
Question.
Let me just check it on my smart app. I had it open already. No, it doesn't target, so you can just easily destroy Borreload. This draw. So at this point, he just banishes the fusion. Might summon a Hawk. Search a Hawk, not so. Okay, so now I'm just talking German, apparently. Yeah, also, sucht sich jetzt den Donnerdrachen Falke. Okay, I'm stopping this now. Hawk resummons the Roar. So. Dum, 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 dum. Bam! There it is.
Yeah.
The Levianir destroying the Nightmare card in the matchup. Like, you hate Borreload as a Thunder Dragon player, and if you can get rid of it like with these, just the plain summon of a monster, you are really happy that you can do that.
But it took also a long time for him to figure that out.
Yeah. Also, good play by Patrick to first use the Hawk effect, because then Titan can't be chained to destroy anything because there's nothing on the field at that point.
Okay.
So summoning the Raw was very good while respecting that there is a Titan on board.
He respecting the play.
Yeah. So he destroys the Tower of Babel with the Levianir and the Titan, apparently. Titan. Okay, so Borreload is not banished, destroyed. I mean, he's probably going to summon his own Borreload and take it over. I don't know his extra deck. Probably another Borreload. Oh yeah, you can summon Diabolos. Like, this already is a Borreload. Yeah, I don't know why Titan doesn't protect himself. I think he maybe thinks that he needs to have Thunder in the graveyard, but it's not the case. I think Titan just needs to see, like, any card, right? Oh, yeah, Diabolos can't be targeted. That's right. So Diabolos can't be shrunk by Borreload. So now he searches out another Hawk, which I find odd as well. I would have expected just a fusion. So now he goes into a Borrowlord on his own to steal the opponent's Borrowlord. And can he go for a game, actually?
Borrowlord battle
begins. I think he maybe just plays Confusion. So searching the Hawk preemptively makes sense. This should be 3k damage. Yeah. 3k damage plus 2-5. Should be minus 500 because he should have activated the Borrowlord effect before it was taken over. Yeah, correct positioning. Yeah, Thunder Dragon Danger is really expensive. That is true. So does Hao have the necessary resources in his graveyard or even in his extra deck? Because you only play one Borrowlord most of the time. If he played a second Borrowlord, he could Borrowlord the Borrowlord to Borrowlord the Borrowlord. And then Borrowlord the Longirsu by the Borrowlord that was Borrowlord by the Borrowlord by the Borrowlord. So there we are.
Ooh.
Scooping it up.
Really hard slap into the face of Hao.
That was such an entertaining game. And I'm still confused why there was no Azathoth. Why would you not run Azathoth? Like, the PK engine isn't that bad. You could... Like, it's fine, isn't it?
What was the monster in the left main monster zone?
The Longirsu. He took it over with Borrowlord. And then he tried
to... Longirsu,
Okay, that was such a nice match.
Germany, we call it oof.
Do we have any Crusadia Guardian players? Can we actually try to find out what the decks in the top 8 cut are?
We could manage that.
Yeah. We should have people tell us that. Maybe it's already on Facebook and just nobody told us. That is also a possibility. I'm just trying to check if this is the case. God damn it. Okay. No, we don't have them. But... We still
have we get them soon.
Yeah, we still have the picture of the amazing HDK exclusive Nessie versus Shizuku mat, which basically resembles the tournament quite well, doesn't it? Nessie versus Shizuku, that's what happened actually. So
what do you predict were the Psyduck chunks now?
Hand traps, kaijus, if there are any in the side deck. I mean, I can look up the list of a different... Okay, thanks for the bracket. Didn't really ask for it, but we wanted
but the now we have a bracket. Better than no bracket.
I mean, we're not complaining. I mean, we are. So I'm just going to look up a E-Man decklist. Not going to spoiler anything. Oh no, I don't have any. Yeah, okay, so that's terrible. Anyways, what cards are sided in Thunder Dragon?
Also, before we think about the side options, now we have the bracket on the... Okay, now the bracket is gone. And now the bracket is back there. What do you guess will be the winner of the other feature matches? So who will we see in the top 4 cut?
I have no idea about the matchups, so I can't really predict anything. I think...
Just pick a guess.
Out of Christian and Zoe, Christian is the more successful player. But Zoe... in the last weeks or month, has shown quite a performance, actually, at tournaments. So she also topped the Italian LLDS stage 2. And yeah, she could maybe go through it all. Tobias Hedrich versus Kevin. I have no idea. Kevin was the guy with the Lockbird and let people go first, right?
Right.
So, not too sure about that one. I'm counting on Tobias because I don't like that strategy because it can backfire so hard. And Lukas Wagner and Nikita Herbst. As I already said, I once dated a Nikita, so I'm in for a Lukas.
Okay. You heard it first.
Yeah.
From Leo. So we can go back on the featured match table.
Yeah, please. Thank you.
And that now, you can tell us what the side options would be for this matchup.
I mean, if you go second, you go side and hand traps. If you go first, you don't. So you go for like something. I have no idea. You basically don't, most of the time, do not side in stuff to go first because your deck is insane going first, right? You put down multiple Colossus and like a Titan and it's hard to out, especially if you expect many mirror matches, then you'd rather side in for going second. I expect hand trips like Gamma or Ash Blossom or Impermanence.
Oh, we see a Sphere Mode.
Yeah. Oh, Sphere Mode, right. That is also an option, actually. If you don't need your normal summon, you can just count on Sphere Mode to out the boards.
It's very good in this situation.
I have seen E-Man players play around Sphere Mode. I mean, I've done the same. Often, if it was possible. Sometimes it's not. Like, in Pendulum, basically, you could play around Sphere Mode. You could go for, like, Double Negate and Omega. That was a valid option. Or One Negate and Omega, because you always had to leave a Link Monster. So, yeah.
I heard a rumor that if you put a Sphere Mode under the microscope and go very, very deep, you see the face of Patrick Dermelin.
This is also an option. yes, you can. But then how can it be used against him? Like, is it just a picture of him being printed into Yu-Gi-Oh cards?
It's like it's bounded to a soul, you know.
So Danger Nessie was summoned into a hand that is not too great.
Also interesting is we have only slightly 9 minutes on the clock. So
yeah, that is true. So Hal actually decided to let Patrick start because his side deck is so full of going second cards, and he expected Patrick to side a lot of going second cards. But at this point, Patrick doesn't have many options. He can just go into a Colossus now after discarding the Thunder Dragon at first. And then banish the Colossus and the Dark from his hand to go into a Titan and activate the Dark effect and then try to find some plays. This might be his option, his main option. He could also summon the Duo later on. It's an additional Thunder summon. So that is a possibility. It also searches another Matrix, so that's fine. Chaos Dragon Levianeer for only banishing light monsters rips apart a card in the hand of the opponent. Okay. As we have learned today. Oh no, it special summons a monster in defense mode. That makes sense.
He go for only light.
Yeah, and he has three dark monsters on the field with different types, so that could be a Curious. Curious plus another monster is a Nightmare Griffin, which is not too effective if the Nightmare Griffin isn't linked. Please tell me that Patrick knows that, because every time I'm casting something, people do that. Summon Curious, send a trap card, a powerful trap card, to the graveyard, and then just think that they can just link up into Griffin. But Griffin prevents monsters from activating their effects if they aren't linked, and that also counts for him. And that is good. Whoa. A raw mill while having Duo in hand is insane, honestly. Yeah, he can summon the Duo now. And immediately summon another monster. Hawk doesn't do too much, honestly. I mean, it looked cool that he has the three new cool Ultra Rare Thunder monsters. But, like, Dark was Dark used? No, he didn't use Dark, right?
No, no.
He has Dark in hand, so that is really insane, actually. Okay, so I take that back. He can search out a Hawk or the Fusion. Damn, that is good.
Fancy shiny cards sponsored by Papa Erkin.
Papa Erkin. Yeah, he will eventually go for a Griffin that it might even be co-linked with a Phoenix. Set back the summon limit, which apparently seems to be really popular right now because dangers take up many summons.
Any budget way to run Orcus, just don't.
Yeah, you kind of... I mean, you can play Orcus Warriors. You can... I mean, even then you have to play like Ibly. Ibly is also kind of expensive, so it's not really possible, I think. I mean, the combo itself is really cheap. All the key cards for the combo, but the way you have to build around the combo is so expensive. So, yeah, no way, Jose, basically, I'd say.
What's also a little bit problematic with Yu-Gi-Oh! If you wanted to start right now...
Yeah, you would have to invest a lot. I mean, you can argue for Salamon Great, right?
Yeah.
If you don't want to spend a lot of money, just play Salamon Great. That's fine. You'll be good then. So Fusion is activated. Thunderdring and Thunderdring Roar.
Boss War? Yeah.
Will be shuffled back to Summon Colossus. Now the question is how he will go into a linked Griffin. Oh no, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Not again. 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 Oh, no. Why? Can we talk to the judges? The judges. Can we talk to the judges? We need to talk to the judges.
I guess yes.
This can't happen again. This can't happen twice in a row. Oh, no. Stop. Why is it linked? Is it linked? Doesn't. I'm an idiot.
But it didn't, though.
No, it is linked when it points to another monster. How can I not know that after. Wow. I am seriously embarrassed right now. This. Yeah, and I know that it doesn't have to be co-linked, but I figured, like, it has never occurred that...
What do you miss about that?
No, like, linking is also, if you point, if the card points to a different card, then it apparently is also linked. I thought it has to be, like, a card has to point to you, to the card that has to be linked. But the card doesn't need a card that points to it, it just has to point to something else.
Natural change.